Okay, now we're ready to move into isolation. Isolating parts of the image for later manipulation. So the tool that we're going to use is the pen tool, and we're going to create paths around and inside the image. Now, if you've worked with Bezier curves and the pen tool in the past, you may be a little worried at this stage, because a lot of people are. It's a big learning curve to get working fast and efficiently with the pen tool, and I had to go through the same process too. I didn't like it for a long time. It was painful. I didn't feel like I had control over it. Everybody goes through that phase getting comfortable with this tool. But what I have is a technique that not a lot of people know, but the ones who do love it, and it makes it so much easier working with the pen tool doing this way. I'm going to show you the standard way first, and then after that I'm going to show you a different technique that's very simple but very powerful, called two-pass clipping. So let's get started with the regular clipping right now. I'll show you how it works, and then I'll show you a better and easier way to do it if you're not comfortable with the traditional way. So I'm going to hit P to go into my pen tool. I'm going to go full screen here by hitting F. That way I can just move my image around wherever I want. I'm going to go into the paths palette and create a new path. Make sure you do this, because if you just start clipping, it's going to create a work path that later, if you go back into that work path and start clipping a new path on it, it's going to delete it. Make sure you have a new path created. And you can actually name it, in this case, silo. This is just a shorthand for silhouette. It's just been around like that for ages, and it's understood by retouchers and designers alike as just the universal shorthand for the silhouette of the entire object. That's what we always start with. So I'm going to move in pretty close. This is a question that a lot of people have when they're first learning about clipping. They say, where do I put the path along the edge of the object? And the answer is, it depends. If you're clipping this out to be put onto a new background, which in this case we are, you can always go a little bit inside the shape, which is kind of nice, because that way we won't introduce any edges of the gray showing through, just because maybe we go a little bit outside the red edge that we see here. That's a nice way to just be safe. You don't want to go too far inside the line, but just with practice, you'll understand where to put the path along the edge of the object. So right now you'll see me do it and just follow my lead for an image that's in this kind of situation. Now, when you first enter into retouching in a professional environment, maybe as a junior or an intern, or maybe you're learning from another retoucher, this is going to be the first step that you really engage in. A lot of prep work needs to be done in retouching. And don't get me wrong, from intern, junior, all the way to senior, seasoned retoucher, we're all going to be doing clipping at some level, probably pretty extensively. It's sort of the foundational work for all of the later retouching that we're going to do. If we can get a good set of paths to isolate the different parts of our image right now, we don't have to worry about that at all later. The analogy that I always use is that it's like a painter taping off a house or a room in a house before painting. So what a painter wants to do is just compartmentalize the different tasks. Now, I'm not a painter, but I know that taping everything off beforehand sets you up for an easy job where you can focus on the painting later rather than worrying about edges and mistakes. This is exactly the same for retouching, because if we can get this set up right now, we don't have to worry about those painful details later of being really careful when we're engaged in the creative process. And it also sets us up for a situation where we don't introduce mistakes into the system.